Hello everybody, Skimmer Kyle here, playing Alien Isolation, episode 2. So, in the last episode, we got pushed off of the Torrids. I can't remember the name of the ship, it began with T, it sounds like Torrids, but I'm not too sure. So we was ejected off of that, put onto this, I can't remember the name of this place either, so it began with S, and I can't pronounce it very well. And basically, ooh, flare. We've got to look for help because we kind of got fucked over by the explosion. So I'm going to have a quick nose around here, see if there's anything of worth. It's a weird noise. Okay, let's just run. Because, yeah, we've actually got the ability to run now. And, oh, brilliant! Loud noises. Ha ha ha. Creepy as all hell. Whoa! I forgot about that. Okay, so I can't go that way, I don't think. Pretty sure. Ah, that's it, I have to go around it. So it's just climb through the vents, which I wasn't happy about in the first place. It's like the beginning to any horror film and horror game. It's just stick them in the air vents, that'll get them used to things. Nah. Don't like that. Don't do that. Okay. So, the employee lounge way we can't actually access yet. A few tubs, things we can't look in. Other pieces. Base flight control, I believe we can't go that way. Doors locked. Leaves us with one option. Employees only. Don't like that sound. Oh! Ouch. Jesus. Christ, okay. Oh, looks like another flare. Okay. Q. Flare. And. Ah. Ah. There we go, I can actually see what I'm doing now. Okay, let's just. Oh. What the fuck actually. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, I went up this way. See some weird shit on the walls. Someone you always know knew a working Joe. Okay. That's kinda weird. Pretty sure there's nothing that way. You can't jump in this game, which is relatively annoying. Anyway, let's just climb up the ladder. Oh, yeah, I keep forgetting that you have to actually carry on walking. It's very light in this room. This makes me happy. A sensor. Turn the radio in. Some scrap metal. Nothing. Okay, let's carry on. Enough time wasting. I'm not gonna lie, this room's kind of creepy. So obviously none of these terminals here are working. We've got a few broken ones. Just gonna run up here. Use these terminals to update the map. Okay, so first things first, we're gonna hit the power. We're gonna spam the power button. I'm loving the new Apple iWatch that my character's wearing. Skronko, bought out from Apple since 2014. Okay, access the terminal. Right, Langley, if you're looking for the stash, I've moved it. You left it right on the open where anyone could have taken it. Jesus, do you know what I had to do to get it? I've hidden it in one of the storerooms. You should be able to find it. The code is 0340. Don't worry, no one goes down to the terminal anymore. Not after what happened. Also, we're out of meds and alarm water, so you're going to need to get some. It's your turn. Maybe it'll teach you to take care of our stuff in the future. From Anna. Wow. Anna sounds like a bitch. Goodbye, Seekson. What's that on? Public note. We've had a long journey together, but sadly it's coming to an end. Seekson Corp would like to take this opportunity to thank all of you who worked and lived at Sevastopol over the years, and hopes that Seekson have helped make it a productive and rewarding environment. Our investment and belief in the station has never wavered. Be assured that Seekson's Apollo Central AI and working Joe Androids will be there to serve Sevastopol until the last rivet is removed. We wish you all the very best for the future. After all, Sevastopol isn't just a station, it's people. It is people. Good job. Seekson Corp. I think there's an audio thing here as well. Kill the power. I'll play it.
Harris, Turner, get back here now. We have a track somewhere in engineering. Lock the terminal down, kill the power, and don't forget your reports. Make them thorough. We're going to need our paperwork to be bulletproof when this shit's over. Wait up.
Okay. That's pretty standard. And finally, power junction. Restore power. People.
I'm going.
There are people. Oh, dog's gonna be a dick. I don't think there's much in the way of stuff. Ah. I think it was 0340, wasn't it? 0340. Yeah, okay. So let's grab some of the bits and bobs, some scrap, that thing. I swear there's a couple of other bits in here. Aha! A med kit, blueprint. I swear there's something else as well. Is there any cupboards or anything? Any little green lights? No? I'm pretty sure I can't make med kits yet. I don't know, let's have a look. Med kit. Oh, hold on, we've got a sensor. Oh, okay, I have got a med kit. We could see. Okay, I've got a med kit now at least. Can I go these ways yet? Oh, bonding agent. It's kind of useful. Can't go that way. Let's see if we can chase the people. No, the light's red. Charge pack, let's take all that. That could be useful. Actually, I think I can probably make another med kit now. But. Yeah, I had enough for like another, but I can't, I have enough for one more. Annoyingly. Anyway, let's press on. I am probably going to just take a quick save here. Because I knew it's there we go. I'm not going to end the episode here, although I'll probably save the game to end most episodes, but this time, I said I'll still do that, but the hell have I got in my hand? It's just Wield of Flare at least, it's a bit more safe. I don't want to waste med kits. Okay, so let's just wander through here. I'm going to duck under this. For that reason, I keep forgetting that the left control is not my my bloody crouch key. C is my crouch key, so I'm actually going to use a med kit now. Hold on. Wait. Ouchies. No, thank you. Do not like that. Apollo. Yeah, all that sort of shiz. This place is lovely looking. This game very reminds me so much of BioShock in this point. Video communications. Ion torch. That door's locked. I know I don't have an ion torch, I haven't got anything. Sevastopol. Oh, Zowie. Oh, there's That's a big ship. I'm here! Contact the Torrens. It's a massive ship. Not that I can actually see it anymore, thanks to the shutters closing by themselves. Which isn't at all eerie, by the way. Thank you, video game. Let's just carry on. Okay. So more video communications, just crouch, I don't have to crouch. There's another thing here. Let's power this place up. I've got to mash that E key. Yes! There we go. Hit the button. And let there be light. Quoting Wheatley, who quoted God. Okay then. Let's just, not freak out of that at all. Can I actually not just that? Oh, I can. Ha! That's weird. Anyway, let's see if there's anything in here we can use. There's a terminal. Is there actually anything of use in this place? Personal. I'm not going to bother the personals. What's Apollo? Apollo Essential AI that monitors and provides guidance for all the Sikhs and working Joes on the Sevastopol. Apollo also oversees all communications on the station, so wherever you are, you know you're in safe hands. So that's not creepy at all. All spaceflight employees. No scheduled flights leaving Sevastopol, nor ships available. Oh, okay. So that's pretty standard. Nothing really in there. I don't think there's anything in this room I can actually loot as such, as far as I can see. However, I can hear a safe. What was that? Blasting cap. That's useful. I can hear a safe point. Yeah, I'll end up this episode here. Right, thanks for watching, everybody. Rate, comment, subscribe, and I will see you in the next episode, Valiant Isolation. And things will probably pick up a little bit more next time. Obviously, I said that last episode, these should probably pick up this time, but we're getting further and further into the story. We need the story, basic set, and getting us ready and into the story, so I'm pretty sure it will pick up soon. We will be shitting our pants and not wanting to go places soon. But, yeah, so until then, bye-bye.